Now, in this topic, we will talk about interlink between demand planning, MPS and MRP. So this is very important to understand how each of them are interlinked and how they are standing in the entire planning process. So in this flow, you will understand that all the requirements from customer orders or sales forecast that is done by demand planner is an input to the MPS. So demand plans are basically at finished goods level. MPS is planning that at item level with different timelines. Then MPS gives an input to MRP, but MRP also takes other inputs like bill of material and inventory file. And from those inputs, MRP gives certain outputs like purchase plan, exception reports or production plan in the form of raw material level plan. Now let's take an example of a bottle manufacturing company. So a bottle manufacturing company manufactures bottle which needs cap, a bottle body and also a label which is pasted on a bottle. Now let's take an example that customer order for the month of May for the bottles is 20 quantity which is already received, and the forecast for the month of May is 100 quantity for the bottles. Now all these inputs goes into the MPS. Now what MPS does, as we have already seen, that MPS plans that on weekly basis. However, we got customer orders or forecast basically in a monthly bucket. Now when it goes to MPS, it plans on a weekly level. So consider there are 4 weeks in the month of May. So in week 1, MPS has planned 30 quantity. In week 2, MPS has planned 35 quantity. In week 3, it has planned 25 quantity. And week 4, it has planned 30 quantity. So total 120 quantity in the month of May is required to be produced or manufactured. Now this input goes to MRP. Now this is one of the inputs to MRP, but MRP also takes input in the form of bill of material. So now we are manufacturing a bottle. Now let's assume that raw material required to manufacture a bottle is 1 quantity of cap, 1 quantity of bottle body and 2 quantities of sticker which are required to manufacture. MRP also takes an input in the form of inventory records. So in this case, so let's assume that on hand quantity for the cap is 100, on hand quantity for the body is 80 and on hand quantity for the sticker is 140. But since we have to manufacture 120 bottles, then we will need 120 caps, we will need 120 body and we will need 240 stickers because each bottle needs 2 stickers. Now considering on hand quantity and required demand, the required quantity to manufacture or to produce is 20 caps, 40 bodies and 100 stickers. Now in inventory record, it is also important to understand which raw material is purchased from the supplier and which raw material is manufactured in-house. So in this case, let's assume that caps are purchased from supplier, even bottle body is purchased from supplier and stickers are made in-house. So cap is purchased item, body is purchased item, body is purchased item and stickers are make item. So based on all this, MRP throws output in the form of procurement plan and production plan. So in the procurement plan, as we know that we have to purchase cap and body from external suppliers. So the procurement plan will include the cap for 20 quantity, body for the 40 quantity, and it will also include the start date to release the purchase order based on the lead time of each item and required demand date. On other side, production plan will also be prepared for the stickers. So in the production plan, it will talk about we will need 100 stickers and it will also include the start date of the production plan. This was one of the simple example that we have seen, but in real life, in the organization, there are thousands of the products. The bill of material is also very extensive for multiple products. Those may have multiple subcomponents or raw materials. And based on that, MPS and MRP plans coming out are very complicated and extensive in the nature.